What's up, guys? Methus here. So 2021 has come to an end, and it hasn't been as busy as we anticipated for. As much as release of new laptop flagships is concerned, a good number of the laptops which can actually be deemed to have dominated, or rather as being the best in their categories, are actually 2020 releases. I mean, there are spillovers from 2020, but they've really performed very well in 2021. So that's why some of them might make into the list. So for this video, the best laptops by category 2021, I have placed them in four major groups. The first group comprises of the gaming laptop, I mean the best gaming laptop. The second group has the best business laptop. The third group has the best graphic design laptop, and the last group has the best student laptop. So each of the laptop in the above groups has a different user preferred aspect, which not only entails the specs, but there are also other miscellaneous features like maybe screen size, resolution, portability, I mean thermal control, those kind of small things that are user specific, if I can say. So let's dive in. The first category is for the best gaming laptop of the year. Here I was so keen on CPU and GPU capabilities. I also had to put into concern the screen resolution and the refresh rate, and also thermal control. And I have three finalists: the ASUS ROG Strix G15, I have the Dell Alienware X17, and the HP Omen 17 gaming laptop. So the ASUS ROG Strix 15 houses an AMD Ryzen 9 5900HX processor, that's for the CPU, and it has NVIDIA RTX 3060 GPU. It's a 15.6 inch 1920x1080 screen with a refresh rate of 144Hz. Then I also have Dell Alienware X17 gaming laptop with the Intel Core i7 11th gen processor. It has both RTX 3060 and 3070 variants, but for competition purposes we'll work with the 3070. Then it's a 17.3 inch 4K display with a whopping 360Hz refresh rate. Surely the best I've ever seen in a laptop is 300Hz, I think. Yeah, in the 2020 HP Omen 15. But this Dell Alienware comes with 360Hz refresh rate. And the HP Omen 17 also made the list with pretty similar specs as the Dell, but maybe the only difference comes with the, which comes with this refresh rate. It has 165Hz refresh rate, and it's a 2K display as opposed to the 4K display with the Dell. Otherwise, it also has a RTX 3070 GPU and Intel Core i7 11800H CPU. So for the ASUS ROG Strix 15, it has the best CPU, the Ryzen 9 5900HX. It obviously beats the Intel Core i7 11800H. But I think because here we are talking of a gaming laptop, if I were going for a gaming laptop, I'd put much concern into the GPU. And so the ASUS ROG Strix G15 having the RTX 3060 means it's the least in the category, and it will take the second runners up position. So we remain with Dell Alienware X17 and the HP Omen 17. Now, both of these two have Intel Core i7 11th gen processor, and they both have NVIDIA RTX 3070. So we only remain with the distinctive feature here would be maybe the refresh rate and thermal control. And for the Dell, the refresh rate is 360Hz, as earlier mentioned, while for the HP Omen 17, it comes with 165Hz. That's a big difference. Then it also, the Dell also has a 4K OLED display, while the HP Omen only has a 2K, 2560x1440. Obviously, that's a huge difference. And then the other thing, for thermal control, Dell Alienware X17 comes with 4 cooling fans, while the HP Omen 17 comes with only 2. It has a dual fan, same as the other ASUS ROG. So with this put into consideration, the second runner-up position goes to ASUS ROG Strix G15. First runner-up position goes to HP Omen 17, and the best gaming laptop of the year 2021 goes to Dell Alienware X17. Second category is for the best business laptop of the year. Well, for this category, a typical user would be looking for maybe say portability, presentability in terms of the exterior looks. Obviously, battery life would be a concern, and maybe port options should be of slightly much interest. Maybe if you don't want to walk around with the dongles, and yeah. So the finalists here are Apple MacBook Air 2020, the M1 chip variant. I also have the HP Spectra 14X360, the GemCut one, and also I have HP Zen 14 Pro G4. It's actually an unpopular model. It's a very premium business laptop, but quite unpopular. So this is the hottest seat for sure. Each of the finalists here has their own unique strength that gives it an upper hand. For instance, for the processor and battery life, the MacBook Air M1 obviously takes it. When it comes to presentability and business-friendly features like maybe touchscreen, say facial recognition, convertibility to tablet mode, the Spectre has it. And when it comes now to graphic capabilities and wide range of options, peripheral ports, I mean, the HP Zen takes it home. So elimination method here doesn't seem to work. So I think for the sake of fairness, we'll have to work with a tie. Yeah, all the three finalists have their own unique features, which actually gives it a better position to be the best business laptop. They all have that extra thing that you need in a business laptop, but nonetheless, I love a tie. Either way, if now you're looking for a business laptop from a personal point of view, then you're open to what do you want in a laptop. For instance, if you want a business laptop that also features a touchscreen, then you'd go for the Spectra. If you want a business laptop that would feature several peripheral ports, you'd go for HP Zen. And if at all battery life is your thing, you want a laptop that would last even 2-3 days on battery, then go for the MacBook. Yeah, so that's pretty it. And so for the best business laptop of the year 2021, we have a tie with MacBook Air 2020 M1 chip, HP Spectra 14X360, and the HP Zen 14 Pro G4. Quickly to the third category for the best graphic design laptop of the year. So this would include both photo and video editing, running Autodesk applications, architectural softwares, and I can say any kind of design software that exists in the world. So the requirements here are pretty close to those of a gaming laptop, and most users actually in this segment often and unknowingly buy gaming laptops instead. Okay, the catch here is with the portability. We are looking for a laptop to be mostly used in an office, then back at home, then on the field. And so this one is more of a mobile and a portable high performance laptop that mimics all the other features of a gaming laptop, like top spec CPU. I'd expect also top spec GPU. I'd also expect good thermal control. But the other catch here would obviously be battery life. You're looking for a laptop that is mobile. It's the same laptop you're using in the office, the same laptop you're using at home and back in the field. I nearly forgot. The screen resolution and refresh rate should be of zero compromise here. Ray tracing and also color accuracy is of much concern when it comes to graphic design. And so my three finalists are the 2020 Apple MacBook Pro M1 chip, of course. Then I have the HP ZBook 15 Firefly G8 and the Lenovo ThinkPad P1 Gen 3. The second runner-up position goes to HP ZBook Firefly 15 G8. It runs on an Intel Core i7 11th gen processor. It has a discrete GPU of NVIDIA Quadro T500. And it's a 15.6-inch OLED touchscreen 4K display. First runner-up position goes to Lenovo ThinkPad P1 Gen 3. It's also a mobile workstation, and it runs on Intel Xeon processor. That's quite a serious one. and so powerful for the CPU, that is. It also has an NVIDIA Quadro T2000, which would be 4 GB, and it has a 15.6-inch OLED touchscreen 4K display as well. Ladies and gentlemen, the best graphics design laptop of the year goes to Apple MacBook Pro M1 2020. And to the final category, for the best student laptop of the year. This comprises of student laptops, budget laptops, and basically ones with the best value for money. Here we are looking for price to performance ratio, and it's a category which most manufacturers actually give vast of options to the market. So here my finalists would be Lenovo IdeaPad 3 14-inch, which I reviewed earlier this year. It featured an Intel Core i5 10th gen processor. It has 8 GB of DDR4 RAM, 512 GB SSD, and it's a 14-inch full HD screen resolution. And I also have Asus VivoBook X515M. That one features Intel Celeron processor, has 4 GB RAM and 256 GB of SSD storage. It's among the slimmest 15.6-inch laptops I've seen this year, which also features a numeric keypad on the right side of the keyboard. So third one would be HP 240 G8, which actually has nearly zero upgrade from its predecessor, the 240 G7. I actually don't understand the difference between them, because when you're given G7 and G8, there's totally zero hardware upgrade. They're both 10th gen processors. Nonetheless, it's made to the list. It has Intel Core i3 processor, 10th gen. It has 4 gigs of RAM and 1 terabyte of HDD storage. It also comes with an extra slot for NVMe SSD, in case you need to upgrade or work with both, for that matter. So for this category, the top spot here goes to Lenovo IdeaPad 3. Second position goes to the Asus VivoBook X515M, and the HP 240 G8 takes the third position. That's more like it. And so let me know what you think. Give me your thoughts on the comment section, and also subscribe to the channel. It would be awesome. Thanks for watching. Enjoy your holidays. Catch you up in the next one. Peace.